Hi Leo, how are you? If you're new, welcome. My name is Michelle and this is your weekly reading. Before I start, I want to remind you guys that my readings have no date. They are divinely guided. Everything has free will. Not everything is going to resonate with everybody. Please keep in mind that roles can be reversed in between energies. And with that said, guys, I want to remind you that this is entirely general. Like I always say, I run all day, so please, please feel free to take or leave whatever you want from today's readings. With that said, let's move forward. Please get one card or two at a time. Please and thank you, Mother. Thank you so much. So right away, we got the Ace of Cups in reverse, the Eight of Pentacles right here, the Nine of Wands right here. We got the High Priestess in that reverse. We got the Three of Pentacles in that reverse, the World, Four of Cups, the Hangman in reverse, and the Seven of Swords in the reverse, the one I did not take. And the Three of Swords in reverse. So we got Libra, Gemini, Aquarius, Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. We got all of them. Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, and Leo, Sagittarius, Aries, to be honest. So I do see right here, babe, that your relationships or romantic sense is not your priority. I do feel like you are trying not to focus on that because it seems like in the past or recently, it hasn't been going well. Not that you're unattractive, because obviously Leo, you're hot as hell, but it's more about like people are not really worth stop being single, if that makes sense. But I do see that you've been focusing a lot in your art and your work. I do see you could be a makeup artist. You could also be an artist. You could actually have a lot of talent. You can actually be this designer, creative person. But I do see you working and being creative a lot. You're focusing on that. With the Nine of Wands right here and the High Priestess in reverse, I want to tell you this because I hope you heal from the things you don't tell people, because I do feel that you are still working on something that did hurt you in the past that you don't really talk about much to people. I do feel like it's nothing about being proud. It's just more about like it's too like a sensitive subject that you rather just not talk about. But I really hope you heal from the things you don't tell others, because I do feel like it's been a very heavy burden to carry. With the Three of Pentacles in reverse in the World, I do see that even though that you're working very hard, you don't understand that you are a piece of art. You're beautiful, you're attractive, you're amazing. And I do feel like the world sees you like this, but you, because of whatever happened, have a hard time believing that at times. With the Four of Pentacles and the Hanged One in the reverse, as I said before, you could have put yourself out there, but nobody has really caught your attention into where you think it's time for you to stop being single. With the Seven of Swords in the reverse right here, I do see you having a hard time trusting, because I do see like your past relationship, they betrayed you or cheated on you in a way. With the Three of Swords in the reverse right here, you are trying to heal the hurt and the bitterness this past person caused. With the Nine of Wands, I do see another fire sign, specifically a Sagittarius, coming into your life or trying to. This person is very fun, very energetic. They are very cute. They could be a tiny bit younger, I will say. The youngest, I see this person being 3 years younger than you. If not, it could be by months. But I don't see somebody that is extremely young. I do see somebody who is very fun. They do color their hair fun colors. They have a very fun and very interesting personality. With the Six of Cups in the reverse, this is someone, this could be somebody that you know. With the Six of Cups, you could have worked with this person at one point and maybe forgot about them, and then you randomly connect with them through social media or in an activity. And that's when you guys, again, get in touch with this person. Others of you could be as simple as you will never date this kind of person because of their age or because of their personality, because you could be a very serious person and this person is quite goofy. But something about that you like. I do see right here that this is a whole different relationship, okay? It's not even compared to anything, excuse me, let me have some water, to anything you had experienced or had before. So this is why this strikes the interest of you maybe giving a chance. With the Nine of Pentacles, the main thing or the first date is going to be for some of you in October around the Pumpkin Patch Farm. I do see that is fall weather. You are looking pretty and very handsome, and this person and you decide to go there. Now, you guys have not kissed, and whenever this happens, you guys have not maybe even felt the attraction, but you guys do feel good and you guys feel comfortable with this person, so you guys decide to go with this person. And with the Seven of Cups, that is when feelings start getting heightened because of how they make you feel, how they make you laugh, how they talk. And that's when the butterflies happen with the lovers right here with the sparkles fly. I do see this connection happening very, very soon. I will say for most of you, by October, this happens. And this is a loving, caring connection. This is like the high school crush and where you get super excited just by breathing the same air as them. So I do see that it's very, very cute, very, very naive in a way. Very new. It's a brand new beginning for you, a brand new feeling. Maybe you haven't felt like this in years. Maybe you have never felt like this. And this is what you say, huh, this person may be the one that gets me off the market. But this is a loving and caring relationship. And as I said this, with the Ten of Cups, Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio, this is the person you end up marrying or being in a relationship. This is long term, and you guys end up having two kids. Now, if some of you, for whatever reason, don't desire kids, and or kids are not in the picture for whatever way, shape, or form reason, that's perfectly fine. This could be either or. They could have kids already. If not, or you have. If not, this could be adding two cats or adding two dogs, because families now are in multiple different ways and everything is valid. Because girl, like I said to people, mind your business. You know, so this is what I see. And getting your little house with the Two of Pentacles, things are maybe getting a little bit more difficult, because whenever this happens, then you have to find time for you, your new family or so. And with the Four of Pentacles, that's when the fear strikes Leo, because you're like, oh my gosh, what if I lose this? You know, like the normal fear. And fear is something that people be like, don't do this. You know, it's okay to feel fear, to be afraid of having something new and having the fear of like, what if I lose it? Because it means something to you. So understand that whenever you feel this kind of fear of like, my gosh, what if I lose this person? Be the person who fights for it. Because it means that this fear is coming to you because you know this is worth giving it a shot. Because you know this is unique. So whenever you have that fear, instead of taking it in such a horrendous way like society likes you to do, take it as this means, Leo, that this is worth fighting for. Finally, with the Ten of Wands right here, you have carried a lot of burdens. And often, like I said before, I hope you heal from the things you never talked to anybody, and to where you were okay with being single with the Empress in the reverse. You were okay with not finding anybody. But here comes the King of Swords, somebody who is committed, somebody that's new, somebody that makes you feel safe, somebody that allows your divine feminine energy, regardless of gender, to come here and allow them to love you. And this is something new. But with the Judgment right here, yes, this happens very, very soon. Suddenly, this is conclusions, end of an era for you, and then starting a new one. And this is something that you could have been praying for a long time. With the Nine of Swords and the reverse, no, they're not gonna play you. No, this is not gonna come and go quick. This is not something like bad. No. With this said, stop worrying so much with the Two of Wands, because some of you tend to worry about the situation and to where you, before something starts, you plan of an exit, and to where you go like, okay, we are here, I'm happy, but let me plan for an exit in case this does not work. Stop doing that. You're bringing negativity where there's no need, because this is positive. They want you to be strong with the Strength card and try to tame the fear, tame the insecurities. Be patient and allow people, specifically this person, to show you. Before you become the judge and the jury, before everything happens, allow this person to show you if there is any worries. But finally, what this says right here, whenever with the justice in reverse and the ace of swords in the reverse Libra energy, you cannot categorize something as bad and expect it to be worth fighting for. So before you become judge and the jury, allow this person to show you. But this said, there's no balance when it comes to you walking away from someone or something before things get bad, or walking into it feeling like, oh, this is gonna go bad to begin with. You know, at this point, there's good people out there, there's possibilities of happiness. You just got to believe it. Sometimes, babe, you are pushed to walk away from someone or something that you thought it was good for you, that you thought it was best for you, and it's because you deserve a lot better. With this said, you need to be open to possibility. You need to be open to love. You need to be open that it is safe for you to love and that you deserve it. But I do see a whole new energy, a whole new person coming into your life with a lot of love to give. And they're coming by October for the most of you. You know what I'm saying? So at this point, boo boo gaga, you need to stop worrying about it. I'm going to give you here some initials. This could be their first, last, middle, or even a nickname, like I said before. Now, okay, we got here M as in Michelle, E as in Edwin, W as in William, R as in Rose, P as in Peter, O as in Oscar, H in Hamburger, J as in Jason, Q as in Kessel, F as in Frank, and G as in George. So these are the possible initials of the person. Like I said before, this could be their first, last, middle, or even a nickname for them. So these are the possible initials connected to this reading today. To finalize your reading, boo boo gaga, I want to give you here the astrological dices. We're going to take a look at the planet, the zodiac sign, and the house, just to finalize on the energy of this. So right now, the planets represent the situation, right? And we got the north node here. Let me take a look at it. And this says, pertaining to what goes around, comes around, karmic cycle, fear of not knowing, destiny, afterlife, and another reality. Now we're gonna go with the zodiac sign, and they represent the emotional side here. And you got Virgo energy, and this says, taking on too much, isolation, overly rational, anxious, focusing too much on details, overly organized, overwhelmed. And finally, we're gonna go with the house. The house represents the area of life, and you have number 6. This represents health, day-to-day activities, hygienic routines, can also relate to pet care or co-workers. So with this said, guys, this is the end of the reading. I hope you guys like it. Leo, please do not forget to like and subscribe. You can comment down below what kind of readings you want me to do. I take suggestions. Also, I want to invite you to follow me on Instagram. I tend to follow back. I'm on Spotify. I do weekly podcasts about spiritual stuff completely free. I'm also on TikTok. I do small short readings over there, different kind of readings. I'm on Twitch. I want to invite you to follow me there, as I'm going to do different lives here and over there as well. Every single platform, I have different content. So finally, if you want to get a personal reading with me, I am open for those. I offer them. You want to check my website. The link is always going to be on the description box below on every video. If it's easier, you can find the link on my bio on my Instagram as well. So with this said, guys, thank you so much for the love and support. Have an amazing day and blessings.